हेलो स्टूडेंट, इन द ग्राफ थ्योरी लेक्चर सीरीज वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड डिजास्ट्रस एल्गोरिदम। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी हाउ डिजास्ट्रस एल्गोरिदम एंड हाउ स्टेप बाय स्टेप इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ द डिजास्ट्रस एल्गोरिदम विद द हेल्प ऑफ द ग्राफ, हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट द शॉर्टेस्ट डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम अ पर्टिकुलर नोड टू द all other node. So before going to the actual example, we will try to understand the basic concept of the Dijkstra's algorithm. Now in this we are going to see the basic of Dijkstra's algorithm. Now see, these are the most important points we have to remember while we are going to actually implement the Dijkstra's algorithm. These points are most important to remember. So basic of Dijkstra's algorithm that we will see in this, basically start this Dijkstra's algorithm basically start at the node that you choose, okay, that is depending upon you. That node is called as a source node. Okay, you have a graph. From that graph you want to find out the shortest path, shortest distance from that source node to all other node. In this case you have to select, as per your choice you can select any node and you can start. So how to select and how to start, what are the step by step, that we will see. So and it analyzes the graph to find the shortest path. This is our target. Analyze the graph to find the shortest path between that node and all the other node in the graph. Okay. Suppose we will take the one example. If you want to travel from Pune to Bombay, in this case, if there are two path, then always you are preferring the shortest distance. Okay, because you want to travel in a short time, and there will be the cost effective traveling should be there, and you are going to select the shortest path. So Dijkstra's algorithm is also helping us to design the real life applications. So in this Dijkstra's algorithm, keep the track of currently known shortest distance. Means if we found the shortest distance, then that distance is considered as a current distance from each node. Okay, from each node to the source node, and it updates the value if it finds the shortest path. Okay, so whatever graph we have, in this graph where initially we are considering the all the distance as an infinity distance, how it is, that we will see along with the example. So once the algorithm has found the shortest path between the source node and another node, at that time node is marked as a visited. Okay, once you got the shortest distance from a source node to the another node, that node is called as a visited node. So next time we don't need to visit that node, and we can add that path is a shortest path. Then next basic thing about the Dijkstra's algorithm, the process continue until the all nodes in the graph. Okay, whatever the process we are going to understand step by step, that process should be continue until all the node in the graph have been added to the path. Okay, we have to select the shortest path. In this way we have a path that connect the source node to all other node following the shortest path possible to reach each node. So this is our target. So whatever graph we have, along with the path, that graph we have to find out as a shortest path. So what is the requirement to understand the Dijkstra's algorithm. In this Dijkstra's algorithm, these four are the basic requirements. It can only work with a graph that have the positive weightage. Now in Dijkstra algorithm, we are considering the weighted graph, and that weight should be the positive. And this because during the process, the weight of the edge have to be added to find the shortest. So there should not be the negative weightage at any vertices or any path. If there is a negative weight in this graph, then the algorithm will not work properly. Keep in mind. So positive weightage must be there. Once node has been marked as a visited, that current path to that node is marked as the shortest path. On previous slide we have seen, and path to that reach that node. And the negative weight can alter this if the total weight can be decremented after this step has occurred. So how it is, that we will see. Only at this point of time you have to remember there should be the positive weight, and once we have visited from one node to another node, that node should be marked as a visited node. So how to implement the Dijkstra algorithm, that we will see step by step procedure. So in this step by step procedure, first step is that mark all nodes are the unvisited. You have to mark all nodes as a unvisited node. So we have not visited any node. We have to mark it is an unvisited node because we don't know. So we will mark as an unvisited node. Mark the picked node as a starting node with the current distance of the zero. Okay, that is your starting, means traveling point. This is your pickup point. You can mark as an zero. And the rest node with the infinity. You can means starting node as a zero, and remaining node is marked as an infinity because we don't know the distance of that particular node. Now fix the starting node as the current node, means which distance you have selected as a zero, that will be your starting node, and you can mark as a current node. For the current node, analyze all of these unvisited. Now in the first step, all the neighbors are unvisited, and measure their distance by adding the current, by adding the current distance of all the current node to the weight of the edge, weight of the edge that connects the neighbor node and the current node. Okay, you will understand this particular point at the time of actual real life example. Okay, just remember this. Now you have to compare the recently measured distance with the current distance assigned to the neighbor node and mark it as a new current distance. Okay, you found the new current distance of the neighbor node. Then after that, consider all the unvisited neighbors of the current node and mark that current node as a visited. Then if the distance node has been marked as a visited, then stop and algorithm has been ended. And else, if not, then choose the unvisited node that is marked with the latest distance, fix it as a new current node, and you have to repeat the process again from step number 4. You have to repeat the process from step number 4. Let's start with the working example of the Dijkstra's algorithm. See, most of the time they are not asking the theory in an exam. They are giving the graph like this, and they are asking and always they are giving the weighted graph. Okay, always they are giving the weighted graph, and along with this weighted graph they are giving the source and destination, and they are asking which one is the shortest path, and display or show step by step execution of the disaster algorithm. So in the above section we have seen the step by step procedure of the disaster algorithm. Now let's study the algorithm with explained example. This is the one example, detailed example. I am going to explain all the points I have covered, and we will try to find out the shortest path of this particular graph. We will calculate the shortest path between C and all other node in the graph. So first of all we will consider the C. Now according to the basic idea about the disaster algorithm, C is the source node, means this is the starting node. This is the starting node. Now just remember, this is your starting node. Now let's start with the step number one. During the execution of algorithm, each node will be marked with the minimum distance to node C, as we have selected the C. So we have to mark the minimum distance to the node C. Now that minimum distance is the 0. Now in this case minimum distance is 0 for node C, and according to the step by step procedure we have to mark all remaining node vertices, or we can, right now for this example we are going to call the node as a infinity. Then for the rest of the nodes we don't know the distance, they will be marked as a infinity except the current selected node, that is the starting node, and we can mark as a red dot. You can observe here, this is called as a source node. So graphical representation of node C as a current node. Okay, this is a current node. Now our procedure is started. Now we are at node C and we have to find out the distance from node C to all other node. What are the shortest distance? Now see the step number 2. Now the neighbor of node C will be the checked. Now this is the source node. Who are the neighbor of this C? That is A, B and D are the neighbor. A, B and D are the neighbor. So we start with the B. And here we will add the minimum distance of the current node, that is 0, with the weight of the particular edge. Now what is the weight of this particular edge? Is the 7. Okay, now that linked the node C to the node B, and we get, that is we will add the current node distance 0 plus the which node we have selected. We have selected node as a B because that B is a neighbor of C, and what is the weight of that edge is the 7. So 7 is equal to 0 plus 7 is equal to 7. Now this is the value we have computed, or we have compared with the minimum distance of B, that is the infinity. Then we will consider which one is the minimum distance, infinity or 7. Yes, definitely 7 is the minimum distance. So we can replace this infinity by the 7. Now we have the new distance, that is the 7 at the B. From C to B we got the 7. Now we have marked and marks the last value to be node B. So in this case we have the distance from C to B is the 7. Then 7 is less than infinity, then we will mark that the 7. So we have assigned node B as a minimum distance value. So yes, we have assigned minimum distance value as a 7. Previous value was the infinity. Now we will see, we have visited B. Now we are not going to visit the B because B was a neighbor of C. Now we will look at the another node. Now the same process is checked with the neighbor A. We will add the distance with current distance, that 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. So previous distance was infinity and infinity is greater than 1. So 1 is less than infinity, then we will consider the 1 is the distance from C to A. So we will replace infinity by 1 because 1 is the lowest value. Now we have visited 1 and we have stored the minimum value, minimum distance of node A. Then at the same time we will see the neighbor, next neighbor node, that is the D, then 0 plus 2. At the same process, whatever the weight of this plus what is the current minimum weight of this is equal to 2. So we have marked, we will replace infinity is greater than 2 and 2 is less than infinity, so we will mark as a 2. Now we got the, we have visited all the node, neighbor node from the C, then we have to remember, we have to mark the visited node. So we will mark this C is a visited node. Now we have marked C is the visited node. Now see here, since all the neighbor of C have been checked, so node C is marked as a visited, as a green check mark. So here you can observe the green check mark. So now this is the node, is a visited node. Now in the same way, now we'll select the new current minimum node, means from this 7 1 7 2 and infinity, which one is the minimum, which one is the minimum, one is the minimum. So we will select the one as a start node right now. Now we will repeat the same process. Now you have to find out the neighbor of A. Now neighbor of A is the C and neighbor of A is the B. Now C is already visited. C is already visited, so we are not going to compute once again the distance from A to C and C to A. We have the distance, that is we have visited, so we will compute the distance. Now here, what is the distance from next neighbor node, that is A to B? A to B, now current distance is 1 and what is the weight, weight from A to B is 3. Now you can add it 4. Now here 4 is less than 7, so we can replace this 7 by 4, because according to the procedure the maximum weight is there because our source node was C. Now we have visited all node from this, all neighbor node, we have computed the distance. Now I am here because my next immediate minimum distance is 1 amongst the all neighbor, so I have selected 1. From this 1 I am trying to find out the neighboring distance. So I have 1 distance, then I can add the weight of this particular A and B with the current distance, that is minimum among all other the nodes, and 1 plus 3 is equal to 4 and 7 is greater than 4, so 4 is marked as a minimum distance from A to B. Then see here, we have marked as a 4 as a minimum distance. Then once all nodes are visited, this was already visited, now new node is visited, now we will mark 1 is a visited as a green tick, and we have one more new minimum distance, that is the 4. Now 1 is marked as a visited node. Now we will move towards the next minimum distance. Now this one is marked, this one is marked. Whatever the remaining node we have, out of that remaining node, we have the minimum distance at node D. So we will select the node D as a source node, and we will repeat the same process. First of all, we will compute, identify the neighbor node from this D. C is the neighbor node but already visited. D to B is not visited. So B and E are the neighbor node of the D. So we will compute the distance from this to this. Now see, D is equal to, what is the current distance? 2 plus 5. That is nothing but the minimum distance plus the weight of this edge. 2 plus 5 is a 7. Now what is his original distance? 4. And already minimum distance is there, so we are not going to replace, we are going to skip this particular path. Then 4 will be as it is, we are not going to do anything. At the same time, we will calculate 2 plus 7 is equal to 9. So we have the 9. We will replace this infinity with the 9. Now we can mark D as a visited node. Now only two nodes are remaining. Now out of these two nodes, 4 and 9. Which one is the minimum? So always we have to select as a minimum distance. So B is the minimum distance. Then already we have visited this one, we have visited this one, we have visited this one. So we are not going to consider all this node. Okay. Now only one node is remain, that is the B to E. And what is the minimum? B is equal to 4 plus 1. That is nothing but the 5, and 5 is less than 9. Yes, so we can mark the 5 is the shortest distance from B to E. So we can replace 9, and we can say that the whatever the distance at E, the 5 is the minimum distance, and we will mark B is the visited because all the nodes are visited. Now we have the only one node to see that. Now is there any more neighbor node? Yes, but all the neighbor nodes are visited node. So we, whatever the current node we have, that node is having the distance, that is the 5, and immediately we can mark there is no any remaining node to visit from E. So we can mark as a 5 is the minimum distance. Now all the node we have marked as a visited node. So we are done. Now unvisited node is left in this particular graph, and we have calculated, we have identified the minimum distance from C to all other node. Now this was our source node. From this node we have computed all the minimum distance. So you can say that if you want to visit from C to E, you can say that which one is the minimum distance. You can visit C to D and D to E, that is 0 plus 2 plus 5, that is the 7. Then here 4 plus 1, 5, yes, 1, 5 and 6. So according to this, 4 plus 5, so this one is the shortest distance from this to this. So in this way you can select any distance from the source node. If your source node is here, then you can select. But at the beginning you have considered as a source node as a C. That's why the distance from C to all node, minimum distance from C to all other node is like this. If you are going to select the other node, there might be the different scenario. Okay, that is depending upon the what type of graph, what is the graph you can compute. So this is very simple things. about the disasters algorithm. So disasters algorithm are one of the most important point in exam. They are asking question about this disaster algorithm for 6 or 8 marks. Okay, for 6 or 8 marks. So you have to represent your answer in this way. You will get out of marks. But when you are going to represent your answer in this way, you should write all this theoretical part. So examiner will understand what you have done. So this is what about the disasters algorithm. I want to discuss.